Okay, good evening. Good evening and welcome, everybody. This lovely space, I think it's used a little too infrequently here at the university for events like this. So my name is George Sampson, and I'm the founder of Arts Administration, that initiative that falls within the Department of Art. Myself, with about 20, 25 arts and men students, have been planning this residency, frankly, for months. So all of us would like to thank particularly Sherry Winston, who oversees the Dome Room, and also Carolyn Dillard, who oversees the Memorial to Enslaved Laborers, where we were supposed to stage a concert on Tuesday night, but we all know that that didn't happen. Both of those people, however, have been wonderfully warm and frankly wise guides to our efforts here in the last few months, and so we want to recognize and thank both Sherry Winston and Carolyn Dillard for that. So there are plenty of others to thank and acknowledge, and instead of my listing them, I'd like to have you turn to the program and perhaps read that list of names with somewhat of the same gratitude that we feel toward those terrific partners in our efforts, and so thank you for that. You know, one of the compelling things that we've come to learn over the years about great abstract art, which I think characterizes tonight's music, is that abstract art provides space for a variety of interpretations, emotions, and perceptions. In the words of a great African-American sculptor, Melvin Edwards, the purpose of abstraction, he said, is to make you think. And while we totally agree with that, I would add also provide space to feel. So I have a couple things to say quickly. The first is a heartfelt statement from the members of the ensemble itself. And they asked me to read this on their behalf. The ensemble would like to acknowledge the events that transpired on the evening of Sunday, November 13. This was actually the very day the ensemble arrived here in Charlottesville. And as we know, three UVA students, Devin Chandler, Lavelle Davis Jr., and Deshaun Perry, lost their lives almost as soon as about the time we were all assembling, actually, on that evening, to gun violence. In the aftermath, we had to immediately rethink what this week might look like for all of us, and so we assembled and consulted with a small group of students, of Arts and Men students, and the members of the ensemble would like particularly to thank Danate Hadish, Justin Kim, Imani Hankinson, and Hyun Chung for lending their voices to the decision to actually continue with these performances here in Charlottesville despite all the uncertainty. As I said earlier, we could not make that happen on Tuesday, and we're delighted to be here. Sorry about the wrinkling of paper, but noise. But we are glad to be here tonight. So these performances this week are dedicated to the lives and memories of Devin Chandler Lavelle Davis Jr. and Deshaun Perry, and offered by the ensemble to the community as part of what will no doubt be a long healing effort. This note was signed by Bill Cole, Warren Smith, Joseph Daly, Roz Moshe Burnett, Althea Sully Cole, Molly Abobswin, Olivia Short. The second thing I have to say requires maybe a little bit of context. It's a bit of a story, I guess. All three student deaths are, of course, tragic in the extreme. Yet one of the three strikes especially close to us tonight. Deshaun Perry was a studio art major, and so I guess you'd say a valued member of the department of which Arts Administration is also a part. Further, he was in a 9-person arts administration seminar class this fall, whose members had formed a very tight bond, in part by taking field trips together. Now, I am not the professor in that group, so I was a witness to only perhaps, I guess, one class, and can't confess to knowing a whole lot more about that, but it still strikes close. One recent field trip was to the gallery called Les Yeux du Monde here in town. I hope some of you may be familiar with it. Quite a few of us feel that it's the outstanding regional art gallery. It was founded by an art department alumna, Lynn Warren, some years ago. Unfortunately, our community lost Lynn last winter to cancer. And in the wake of her passing, her daughter, who's also a UVA alumna, took over. So Arts Administration has provided student interns to Les Yeux du Monde for many years now, including at least one student who's there right now as an intern. It was therefore highly appropriate that a field trip was arranged for this Arts Administration seminar class to visit that gallery. This week, in the wake of the of this tragedy, the gallery owner wrote the Arts Administration instructor a note from which I will read some excerpts. She wrote, "I have wonderful memories of Deshaun from our very brief time together, and I wanted to share these with you. This group of students you brought to the gallery," now again, this is not directed to me, but to a colleague, "that you brought to the gallery were exceptional, a special group as you noted. But Deshaun really stood out even among that special group. I noticed immediately upon meeting Deshaun that he had the biggest, kindest smile. I was then impressed that throughout my talk by how engaged and thoughtful he was, giving his undivided attention," and she writes in parentheses, "something that frankly feels quite rare from anyone in this digital age, and asking wonderful questions. But what sticks," "what sticks in my mind the most," most now, "is the way Deshaun waited around at the end of class so that he was the very last student to leave the gallery. And then he approached me to talk to me about his own artistic pursuits. He first told me that he was an artist, and then asked for advice on how to promote his art to the world. He even said that he was interested in interning at the gallery, which I was blown away by, given how busy I know he was as a D1 athlete. I was struck by how genuine and earnest he was, and also by the breadth of his passions, from athletics to visual art. He was clearly a multifaceted, talented, yet humble young man with big dreams and both the drive and the disposition to make them a reality. I am so incredibly devastated that Deshaun was robbed of that future." She concludes by saying, "I would love the opportunity to see Deshaun's artwork at some point if the opportunity ever arose. In the meantime, I just wanted to share these thoughts while they are still on my heart. I am so sorry that you have lost such a special student, and I am so beyond heartbroken for Deshaun's parents who have lost such a special child." So I'm going to ask all of us, if we would be willing to do this, to engage in a moment of silence and suggest silence be broken by our distinguished guest artists with their first sounds, whatever choice of sound that is, of the healing magic of music. Thank you.
Thank you. I Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Woo! Thank you very much for coming out this evening. Hope you enjoyed our performance. We had a great time, as we always do. You know, if you're gonna play it, it's Mouth. That Mouth, Mouth will have a good time. My far left. Far left, Tyner O'Bottom. Back on all the drums and all the bell phones and all the whatever that can be struck, Warren Smith. Ross, Mr. Ross of Brooklyn. Molly Obafson went up behind me on the bass. Olivia. Olivia. Good. Sad moment, you have to have some joy because, you know, we know what the world is like, and all over the world, people are slaughtering each other, if not by guns and hand grenades and missiles and anything else they can put their hands on. Some just want to walk up to you and strangle you to death. But we don't do that. We provide music to uplift you, uplift your spirits, make you feel good, make you leave this spot here and say to yourself, that was really fun. So thank you very much for showing up. We really appreciate it. And we really appreciated our time here in Charlottesville. Thank you very much.